Well, it was at a time when we needed to bring somebody new to run our product development.
You weren't happy with your product line.
Clearly, we needed to. We were doing a good job in a lot of the, you know, working quality, durability, but we needed to get more, if you will, zip in our style. And so I went to see Bob. At that point, he was retired. He was actually running a supplier company. And I went to see him on Friday morning, and I said, "Hey, Bob, I'm looking for, you know, the next Bob Lutz in the industry." And so we talked through all of the product development people around the world, and finally concluded there wasn't another one. And so I said to Bob, "I don't think I was completely joking, but maybe a little bit. Well, you wouldn't be interested in the job." And he says, "Don't assume that." And really, within a couple days had passed, he had decided to re-enlist with us. And he's just done a terrific job since then.
He's an auto man's auto man.
He is. The reason he likes doing this, despite being well beyond our normal retirement age at the company, is because this is his hobby. And so he gets to come in and basically do his hobby every day, which is automotive design, next generation products. He's a real champion of the Volt. So Bob's been a great addition to our leadership team. He contributes in other areas because he's got great business experience, but he's really energized our design team, which I think is that in the Volt will probably be the most important contributions he makes of many here.
The Malibu, the Cadillac, was it CTS? Those are two cars that won Motor Trend Awards and all the other kinds of things. And so did you. In 2008, Motor Trend said the most powerful, the most interesting, something executive. This was at a time that all these things were in place. How long do you want to stay as CEO of General Motors?
Well, I have been in the job for a pretty good while. In that sense, I guess since 2000, someone was telling me, "Boy, it seems like you've been around forever." I said, "Boy, try sitting in my shoes. Time goes pretty slow here sometimes." But they have written your
death knell too a number of times.
A number of times, yeah.
When General Motors, you know, had the kind of losses that you've had to face and the kind of crisis you had to face, and people saying this is not even a car company, it's a healthcare company.
Sure. So I guess at this point, Charlie, just turned 55 this year, and you know, a lot of companies, the guy becomes a CEO when he's 55 or 56 or 57. So I'm still really enjoy the business. I feel like what we're doing is exciting. You don't often get a chance to be part of reinventing an industrial icon that I think is so important to our industry and our country. So I'm planning on staying around and working with our team and driving us into our next 100 years.
Okay, so reinventing an icon, which is General Motors, which is America's love affair with the car. I mean, is it 10 years from now, when you'll be 65, yes?
Yes.
And you might think about retiring at that time.
I'm not going to be a Bob Lutz, I can promise you that.
Who's 75 or something?
Unbelievable.
Or maybe even.
Yeah.
All right. So, I mean, reinventing General Motors. So, at 10 years from now, in 2018, we'll see the Volt have been successful.
Hopefully,
or
see
not.
A lot of those, yes.
Yeah. Will the internal combustion engine be over?
I don't think so, Charlie. I think the change is going to be more gradual than a lot of people think. I guess it sort of depends on the circumstances. But, you know, petroleum is a very cost-efficient source of power. And, you know, we've got internal combustion engines. They're very high quality and, you know, despite concerns, quite low emitting. So I think we're going to have a period which I would guess, you know, might be more like 20 years than 5 or 10, where the industry moves and tries different technologies. We've talked about the battery today, but, you know, we have proponents of fuel cells, a lot of interest in biofuels. And so I think it's going to be somewhat of an unsettled period for 5 or 10 years as we begin to really sort out which technology is going to be the biggest winner. And I think a number of them will coexist for a significant period of time. And I believe internal combustion engines, four specific uses, will be around for, you know, certainly for the remainder of my career. And I suspect, you know, at least another 10 or 20 years beyond that.
Let me just talk about a few assets. A Hummer's for sale.
Right. You want to buy it?
No.
It's a great brand.
Yes. Well, who is going to buy it?
We've had plenty of interest so far. To be honest, we've kind of been doing the stuff you need to do to potentially sell an asset, you know, put the financials together and stuff. But while we've been doing that, we've been getting quite a bit of interest.
GMAC going to be okay? I mean, you own half of that, 49%.
Right. Yeah, they're taking some tough measures. No? At this point, no. What we're trying to do is work with them and our partners in ownership of GMAC to help them get through what's a tough period, frankly, in the financial markets. And GMAC is certainly
been affected. And they own some big real estate company.
Right. Right. Yeah. That's the ResCap, which has been a very tough business for us. It was great for a while, and certainly the last couple of years we've suffered, you know, like the rest of that industry in a very tough way.
So in downsizing cost and selling assets to increase your liquidity, what else might be there for you?
Well, our general view has been, let's try to keep the things that are core to our business, which obviously is our global growth, technology. We like to do a lot of our own powertrain work. So those are the kind of things we plan to keep. And then I think, you know, beyond that, you know, over the years, we've been willing to consider selling other assets. And I just say for today, you know, we've announced, the Hummer one, but we're looking at some others that might make sense to either sell or partner with someone else, trying to find creative ways, if you will, to generate the cash we want. And make sure we either get the value of the asset or set ourselves up to grow the asset and still participate in it. So can't really give you a list of at this point, but you know, as we get ready to take them to market, you'll be able to question me about them then.
All right. One last question. What's the most important thing you've learned in the last 5 years?
Oh, I think the most important thing, and you know, we learn it and relearn it in this business. If you don't have the best product, you're not going to win for the long term. So every day when we come into business, we have to worry about, you know, restructuring stuff and healthcare costs and, you know, things like that. But boy, you got to make sure you spend enough time understanding what consumers want today, taking a view on what they're going to want in 5 years, and then really make sure you've got the best design and product development team and give them the room to run and the financial support and funding to do that. Because if we don't do great products, over time, you're losing ground. The day you decommit to outstanding products, you start to lose ground.
Now, is that what happened? Is that why Toyota has replaced General Motors? And is that what is the mandate for General Motors to have better products than anybody in the world? Although I know you think you do have that when you look around the world. But is that, in fact, what happened that you've had to make it your mission to change?
It's critical to our mission, and I think it's fair to say at points in our history we maybe didn't execute as well. The other point, Charlie, is what makes a great product kind of changes over time. First of all, if you had high quality, that was kind of good enough, and now everybody's got pretty good quality, and then you want the latest features, and you know everybody's pretty close on features. What is always important is great design, and this is what Bob is talked about since he came here, is that we need to do all this other stuff. It's so important to have great quality, for example, but people look at a car and are captured initially by the design and the execution of the interior, and so that is something that, you know, we've really put up is a super high priority. Keep pushing ourselves on design and don't get satisfied with where we are. If you got a great car, the next one has great design, the next round has to be even better. And it puts a lot of pressure on our designers, but they like that.
It's great to be here. Thank you very much for spending this time with me.
Thanks, Charlie. Good to be with you.
Rick Wagoner, Duke Man, CEO, General Motors. Thank you for joining us. We're in Detroit.